who have never seen a bat before, this is improv done in the dark. So we are going to turn off the lights in a second, but I highly, highly recommend that you close your eyes. Our eyes will be closed too. Yes, I am asking you to put some work into this, but I promise it'll be so good when we get there. Now, to start us off, can I get a non-geographical location?
Post office.
Space.
Post office.
No.
Post office.
Thank you.
Red lights, please.
Channing, I mean, this air is so bright. Why can't I have some kind of shade to, if you had anything to recommend?
Oh my gosh, Jennifer, do I have something to recommend? Get over here and try this out. I have this shade for you that I...
We interrupt this broadcast of Shade in the Way to bring you to a scene from a post office.
Mail.
That is flying everywhere.
Stamp licking.
Slow moving employees.
Overstuffed mailbags.
Wheels squeaking on the floor.
There's a tottery old postman with a short mustache.
We see he has a giant smile on his face.
Oh, I love this job. I've been working here at the post office for 4 to 5 years.
We see a little old lady walk up to the front of the front desk.
You can tell that she's wearing this wonderful tweed suit. It's like powder pink.
Stan, I have my monthly package to send to my son, Robert.
There's a very bored-looking teenager.
He has on a backpack.
Yo, I don't wanna get a job, but like my mom says I do, so I guess.
We interrupt this scene to take you to the teenage boy's home on a Friday afternoon.
Ma, I didn't get the job at the grocery store. I'm sorry.
What? You don't even have to do any real work at the grocery store. The application is only half a page long as a postcard.
I know, but like it was kind of small, and my pen wasn't working right.
What? Your pen?
My pen was like I have it in me. It's not my passion.
What? Working? Working is not your passion? Working? You have the job. You need a job.
No, that's the part of it. Maybe I don't work. Maybe I could be like a social media influencer.
We interrupt this scene to take you to the end of the postman's day.
This is the most value-driven job. I feel so fulfilled. So this is everything. People are wishing they could be like me. I even talk to myself while walking and getting into my viper. Yeah.
We see that he's standing in a very large room with bags and bags of mail strewn everywhere, clearly not sorted. Hey Jerry, we got another thing of mail from Piscataway.
Piscataway? I went to Piscataway in 1972 and met this woman named Babalu.
Jerry, it's the stories. You gotta stop with the stories.
We take you to when Jerry met Baby Blue.
Baby Blue? You caught my eye too.
Oh, Jerry, you just say the nicest things and you rhyme when you do it.
I do it right, and I do it tight.
Jerry, you are just so handsome and poetic.
I like Lacey Hughes. Can you be my boo?
Tell me about your childhood in some kind of rhyming way.
A scene with the little old lady 30 seconds before she came to the post office getting out of her car.
Oh, my little Robert, he's gonna love this package. I got him his special peanut M&Ms.
We see that she is driving up slowly to the post office at a speed of 0.05 miles per hour.
Honk, 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 honk.
Get out of the way! Get out of the way!
What was that, sir? What? I can't hear a thing.
Get out of the way, lady! Come on!
There are 12 cars behind her.
Honk, honk, honk.
Oh, my goodness. Wait a second. I forgot the to-go tissues.
She bends down to reach for her tissues.
Oh, Robert,
three more cars have joined.
Package. I'm gonna have to stop here for a second.
At least pull over to the side.
Hi, sir. Oh, hello, sir. Yes, I'm just gonna be 1 minute here.
We cut to the old lady with Robert when he gets one of the gifts.
Oh, Mima, you sent me a package like 6 weeks ago, and now you're here with me.
Oh, baby, I couldn't wait to see the look on your face when you see the little surprises that I got you.
Mima, I feel like you could have mailed that, or just, you know, hopped on a plane and took it to me. And then you would have been there in like a day.
No, baby, I want it come through the mail, because that's where love comes from.
Oh, Mima, you love me so much, but it says on the box that it has perishables.
Oh, yeah, baby, I bought you some goodies that you like. Open it up already.
The box opens, you see all kinds of like rotted salmon cakes and like all kinds of chicken, like this nasty little
thing. Oh, Mima, it's your home cooking. Oh.
Baby, I made a Friday night dinner like we used to when you lived with us growing up, and I just packaged it up for you.
You see a whole bunch of beans, just random beans all at the bottom. She did not put it in Tupperware. They just dropped it in the box.
Well, I made you a plate. I fixed you a plate like you were at the table, and I just dumped it right in.
Oh, Mama, it's so sweet. It's just like, couldn't you have come here and made it?
You cut to a scene at the post office with the old man looking at the box that the old lady just sent.
Well, this thing stinks.
In my 45 years, have I seen something so wet and soggy and stinky?
Jerry, does that say express mail, or does that say take 6 weeks extra?
Well, let me get my spectacles and it says, U.S. Mail, P.O. Box 1, I think that's a 7, 2, 3, not, what did you ask me, son?
We now cut to a scene of a teenage boy applying for a job at the post office with Jerry.
So, you guys do mail and shit? Is work involved? I'm not into that.
That's the problem with you millennials. Work! Don't you know, in 1972, I had 4 jobs, plus 2.
Oh my gosh. 4 jobs, that's more, adding that up is more work than I want to do. But you look like really like old and shit. Can I take a photo of you for my Instagram? Like, I'll get a whole bunch of likes. Because you got like those spectacles, which are definitely old.
What? What are you talking about? I have a camera right here. I just gotta put some film in it, and I ain't really here, all right?
Oh my God, it's so much work. Oh my God, I can't do that.
All right, so I got the little umbrella thing, and it's on the, you see the umbrella, it's on the stand. All right, come on, Sadie. We can put this in the newspaper, right?
We can see that the line behind the post office counter has grown to 25 people during this conversation.
Don't you know I used to be a photographer part-time while I was in the post office back in 1989?
I think you got people waiting. 1989 is a really long time. That's 19 years, 29
years. We now cut to a scene with a teenage boy asking his crush on a date.
Hey, Gina, you're cute, and like, would you come out with me? I don't really want to work for this. I don't want to put an effort to our date, but like, you're cute.
Oh my god, you're so cool.
Yeah.
It's like, do you really want me? I don't think so. It's kind of hot.
I mean, I do want you, but like in an effortless way.
God, it's so hot.
But like, you're so cool, kind of. Like, I don't really know what I want to compliment you with, but just like, you make something up.
What?
Yeah. Oh my god, it's like the sweetest thing anyone's said to me.
It's just that easy.
Cut to the old woman writing a letter to her best friend.
Dear Belinda, I made the most delicious Sunday afternoon dinner. I made my meatloaf, and I put some milk out like Robert was here, and it was almost as sweet as that dinner we had when he was 12 years old living with us every Sunday.
We see steam rising from an empty, from an open box next to the table.
Robert's asked that I not send him these packages anymore, so I'm sharing this meatloaf dinner with you. I love you, Belinda.
A mixture of milk and marinara sauce from the meatloaf drips slowly out of the packaging.
Please come and visit soon, and I'll cook you a fresh one.
You now see Belinda at home writing a letter back to the old lady. Dear Juanita, I received your package about a week ago, and it was postmarked 10 November, and it's actually 7 May today. This is the most beautiful dish I've ever seen. Did you put saffron in the meatloaf? You are so smart.
We see Belinda's cat go over to sniff the package, lick it, then puke a little bit.